Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Let's discuss how to use the tools which measure current and electric potential difference, starting with the ammeter, which measures current or number of amps. We need to decide if an ammeter needs to be put in series or parallel with the circuit element it is meant to measure the current through. So, let's look at what happens when we attempt to measure the current through a resistor using an ammeter in series and in parallel with a resistor. Billy, tell me what you see.
Yep, I can do that. Well, it looks like when you put an ammeter in parallel with resistor, the charges which go through the ammeter will be different from the charges which go through the resistor. So putting an ammeter in parallel with a resistor will not actually measure the current through the resistor. So an ammeter needs to be placed in series with the circuit element you are trying to measure the current through.
Correct, Billy. And notice that the resistance of an ammeter needs to be very, very small. In this example circuit, if the resistance of the ammeter is not very, very small, the ammeter will increase the equivalent resistance of the circuit and decrease the current through the resistor you are trying to measure the current through. So, unless otherwise indicated, ammeters in this class are considered to have zero resistance. And I'll just mention that because ammeters have such a low resistance, if you accidentally place an ammeter in parallel with the electric load of a circuit, you are significantly decreasing the resistance in the electric circuit, which can significantly increase the current in the electric circuit. And this can really damage equipment. So please, never put an ammeter in parallel. Now, let's switch to a voltmeter, which measures electric potential differences or voltage. Let's attempt to measure the electric potential difference across a resistor using a voltmeter either in series or in parallel with a resistor. Bo, tell me what you see.
Sure. Placing a voltmeter in series with a resistor actually does not measure the voltage across the resistor. I mean, the voltmeter and the resistor would have different electric potential differences. So I guess you have to place a voltmeter in parallel with the circuit element across which you are trying to measure the electric potential difference.
Correct, Bo. Also notice that the resistance of a voltmeter needs to be very, very large. In this example circuit, if the resistance of the voltmeter is not very, very large, the voltmeter will provide a parallel path and decrease the equivalent resistance of the circuit, and that will increase the current delivered by the battery, which changes the way this electric circuit behaves. The tools you use to take measurements should not change the circuit you are attempting to measure. So, unless otherwise indicated, voltmeters in this class are considered to have infinite resistance. To review, ammeters measure current, are placed in series with the circuit element you are measuring, and have nearly zero resistance. Voltmeters measure electric potential difference, are placed in parallel with the circuit element you are measuring, and have nearly infinite resistance.
Why didn't you just start with that? That table only took you 41 words to say. It took us 461 words to describe all the reasoning behind the table. All we really have to do is memorize the table.
Because we have to understand why ammeters are placed in series and why voltmeters are placed in parallel.
And we have to understand why ammeters have nearly zero resistance and why voltmeters have nearly infinite resistance.
It is the understanding that really matters.
Yeah. It is easy to make mistakes when trying to recall memorized facts.
You are much less likely to make mistakes when you understand something.
I could not agree more. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.